I think there's two things at play here. If you have like very good experience, maybe a very good like couple of days, and then shortly afterwards you kind of balance into more negative feeling and ideas, then that is quite different from, let's say, when that more like comes after a week, 2 weeks, a month. So if it comes quickly afterwards, then the problem probably is that you have given too much importance to that good experience you have attached to it. You know, however good that experience was, it did not make you enlightened, you know? It just, was a step forward. In that way, it should also not be doubted, you know? It was a good experience and you made some step forward, you had some insight, you released something, and suddenly you feel so great, and you know. But then we tend to attach to that. And then whenever we encounter then something else, which anyhow is still there and was not solved or touched by that experience or that step, that growth, then if we have attached very much to that good feeling, then that new bad feeling, it comes like a hammer, you know? Because we don't expect it, you know? We somehow believe we were out of it. So there, no, equanimity always means that we are equal in our feeling, whether whatever happens is pleasant or unpleasant, feels great or feels like it sucks, you know. It's in both, we should keep a distance and not attach. Because otherwise, anyhow, if we attach to that good thing that happened to us, there'll be some disappointment naturally coming afterwards. And the higher you fly, let's say, the lower you fall. You know? And with flying, I don't mean having a good experience, because that's really good. You know? With flying, I mean like taking that experience and feeling you're on top of the world and like you got it figured out. And, you know? So I don't know in your case if that's really like what could be there, but still, that is typical in many people. Once we've had a taste of a bit of like enduring happiness and deep like feeling of bliss, then we are again in confrontation with some darker aspect of ourselves. It's hard, you know? So yeah, that is part of it. Another part, and that's more when you know, we're talking about a longer time between that great experience and then something new which comes up and creates a problem for us. That is actually very naturally a karmic effect. No? Let's say if there's 1,000 unresolved issues in your subconscious mind, then at this particular time, only a few of them are coming to the surface. Because that's what you can handle, let's say. No? And that's what you're working with, and as long as you're doing that, the other things will wait, you know, will stay down. But then when some of these things, we really kind of resolve them, whichever way, and then they go, and then maybe we get a bit of a holiday, let's say, where there seems to be no real problems, then something new will come up. And it will either directly just come up from the subconscious into the conscious and start affecting our thoughts and our feelings, or it'll create something outside of us karmically that then brings this problem to us. In both ways, it works. So that is more on the longer term, you know? Even some people may experience 1 year without any real problem. And everything seems fine and going well, maybe a little this or that, but generally speaking, you know, they're feeling fine. Don't attach to it. Because naturally something more will come and create a new problem, which will require like a new solution or a new attitude or a new understanding to be dealt with. You know? So in that way, gradually, things are coming out and are cleaned out in that way. And so, yeah. That way we move forward. So we should always be happy to move forward. Whenever we see something there happening, no, we can be happy because of it. But know that it is just again a phase, is just again a temporary feeling that comes. Just as whatever negative thing came before was just a phase and just a feeling which comes. You know? And try to stay, you know, in that place where these things don't matter. You know? Where there is a certain detachment from all these things, from all these feelings, whether good or bad. You know? Whether pleasant or unpleasant. And then, okay. That doesn't stop that, of course. But it certainly makes then newly arising problems or issues much more easy to handle. Then you're like, okay, next phase is starting. Let's do that. Let's just try to deal with that. But stay calm, stay detached, stay in our center, believe in our progress, believe in ourselves, and believe in, you know, the self, which is ultimately, you know, the reality anyhow. It's like a child, no, when it's bored of going to school, and then comes a holiday, and and it attaches so much to that holiday that if that holiday after, let's say, 5 days is again gone and they have to go back to school, that it's like so terrible to go back to school, no? Because they've been attaching too much there. So in that way, it's natural. Children do it, so don't blame yourself. It's natural. But try to see it happening. And whenever you see that happening, stay calm. This is again related to self-confidence. No? When we tend to attach too much to whatever good thing we've done, whatever good evolution is there, whatever step we've taken forward, is because we are trying there to feel more confident about ourselves. That is then creating the problem. No? So we should always find our self-confidence elsewhere, in the self, in the unlimited potential that we all have. Yeah, I think many people, when they get into this, in the beginning, they think the ego, I'll deal with it, I'll get rid of it, I'll handle it. But once they start working with it, then there are these moments when it feels like, wow, this is an impossible task. And especially once we discover the subconscious part of it, and then understand that thinking differently about something is very helpful, but does not solve it, does not change the feeling that comes from the subconscious. And in that way, then, it can be discouraging. But we're all on the same boat, There, we all have that. Yeah, and it has a lot to do with the energy, with your feeling, which is your energy. And so once your energy becomes again a little bit darker, all sorts of stuff comes out. The ego anyhow, we should not blame it too much because it doesn't exist even. It's just an idea. But energy-wise, for sure, what you are saying is correct, that once then such little bit of negative thinking starts coming, the energy starts changing, then suddenly it's like an avalanche. Like for a couple of days, there were really few negative thoughts at all. But then at some point, something, whatever, triggers it. But once triggered, that energy takes over, the feeling changes. And when the feeling changes, the thoughts change, and whatever comes up, reflects the energy. So, in that moment, we have to be quick. We have to see it coming. And we have to, see that first negative idea about ourselves or whatever, and nip it in the bud by changing the energy. There, if we are going to start working on the thought level, it can be helpful, but the main thing first is to change the energy. Now, on the thought level, what we actually have to do then is say, not today, guy. I'm not interested. I don't want you. I'm good. I don't want to go there. And just take a distance. But then the next step should be, to change the energy somehow, chanting, meditating, having a cup of chai, whatever works, no, to bring that positive energy again and reconnect to the heart, no, reconnect to the good feeling. And then that avalanche can be avoided. But if we only try to, like, say no, because that anyhow we will naturally do, no, I don't want this, but we don't do anything on the energy level, on the feeling level, then that is stronger always. No? We talked about that some weeks ago, that I said that our conscious thinking is such a limited part of who we are. And in all other parts of who we are, in the physical body, in the pranic body, in the subconscious, what we find most of all is feelings. And they are very powerful. And so that's where then, you know, we can try to work whichever way that works for us. And fight the battle, let's say, against negative thinking on that level. And try to keep the thoughts silent, rather than trying to go against it. You know? When such a negative thought comes about ourselves, then we might think to, you know, come up with counter thoughts, positive thoughts, and say, oh, but yes, this, that, you know, anyhow, I'm great, you know. But that has little power if the energy is not there. It feels hollow. It feels like, yeah, a story. It feels unreal. And so then more negative thinking will come. And whatever, like, positive thoughts before were very much supporting us, maybe now they will get a twist and become negative and seem like an illusion and seem like unreal. And of course they are, no? Whatever idea you have about who you are as an individual, where you are, how good you are doing, how bad you are doing, is all just an illusion. No? The only thing that's relatively real is your feeling. So we should very much stay focused there and work with that. And the thoughts then naturally follow. No? Nothing wrong with positive thinking, of course. No? But if unsupported by positive feeling, they have little power. There will be like a dog biting its own tail. You know, not work very well.